In the previous video, we graphed this right here. This is the Bode plot, if we were to do it in phase form. Now, it would be nice to actually get rid of these values, because we're only concerned about the polar, which is the degrees. We have 90 degrees, negative 90 degrees, and 180 degrees. These are the specific angles that we really need to be concerned about. Because I'm doing it on OneNote, it's not going to be as accurate if you were to write it on a diagram or to if you were to use some kind of software to do it. So that is the phase, and now we're going to graph the magnitude. I mentioned it previously, it's right here, and now we can actually graph it. So in graphing the magnitude, we are going to have to make a zero point. So in our magnitude right here, and I'll just call this mag for magnitude, we're going to have a zero right here. We'll have like a negative 20 here, negative 40, and a negative 60. And then we have a 20, we have a 40, 60, and so on and so forth. So this is our A, dB, and then we have our omega here. When we look at this, remember we're only looking at this magnitude right here. Everything we did earlier was for phase, but it helped us come to this conclusion. So for this part, we have three things that we need to graph. First thing that we're going to need to graph is this part right here. In this part, if we look at the notes linked below the like button on page 96, we can see that this is a k, and it's going to be 20 log base 10 k. So what we are going to be graphing is what we found in the second part, or the third part, sorry, adb at 1 rad per second. So we're going to be graphing about approximately negative 10. So graphing negative 10 is going to put us around this range. So we have a negative 10 right here, and this is going to go the entire length right along here. So we can write this as negative 10 point, I think it was like 103. Now we are going to look at the next part, and this part right here is very, very similar to what we have in the, I think, fourth row. And in the fourth row, we start at our z, and then we go to our omega. Our z here is 200. We should have written this in, but I totally forgot. So I'll just do it in blue here, but this is basically 1, this is 10, this is 100, this is 1000. And so if we have 200 for our z, it's going to be somewhere around here. That means everything before this is going to be a zero. So it's going to be along this zero line right here until it reaches this 200. Once it reaches this 200 right here, it's going to go up at 20 n per decade, because we don't have any n outside of here. We just have a regular n. And so this is just going to go up until it reaches to our omega. And our omega, it's just really going to keep going on and on. So at 20 per decade, and a decade is every one of these, we are just going to be going something like this. And it's just going to keep going up and up, and then we could just keep going. And so now we can move on to the next part, where we have this last part. We can see that it's a negative, so that's actually going to be very important to pay attention to. So looking at this part, what we're going to graph is similar to the second to the last magnitude factor. And we're going to graph that. We can see it's moving at 40 n. This is different from the one we underlined in blue, which was moving at only 20 n. This one is steeper because it's moving at 40 n. And since it's a negative, as we said right here, it's a negative, it's going to be going in the negative direction. And then we're going to be going from 0 to 80. And the 80 comes from right here. So we're going to take this 80. This is our omega n. We're starting at omega n. So that's super important. Starting at omega n, it'll be like right here. We'll say that this is 80. Say 80 is equal to our omega n. We get that from earlier. We solved that in the previous problem. And the way we solved it was in step 2 up here, right here, where we found the lower and upper omegas, and then we add them together and divide it by 2. That gives us 80. And so knowing this, we can just graph this part out, And so it'll go to zero right here. And then after this, per the graph, it's going to go down at 40 NdB per decade. And so it's going to look a little bit like this. This is inaccurate, but it's just going to be something like this. And really, it should be a little bit steeper. But compared to the other one, it's pretty steep still. So it's just going to look like this. And now the actual Bode diagram is the summation of all of these three. And we'll do that in green. I guess I should have done this. We'll just say that the green right here is equal to the gray, just so you don't get the colors mixed up. And I guess I'm gonna do the Bode diagram in this light blue or aqua. And so if we add all these together, that means we're going to come down here with this negative 10. I'm not gonna draw right over it, I'll draw right under it so we can still see the negative 10. We can see that our first inflection point, and this is for magnitude, this is magnitude inflection, not phase, it's going to be right here. And then our next one is going to be right here. And knowing this, we can start graphing and we'll have it go here. And we can see that it's flat here, so we don't need to worry about that. It's also flat at this next part, the red part. So what we can do is just look at the gray part, and then it's gonna go like this. And then from here, we can see that we need to factor in this part with this part. And so knowing that, what we can do is just add them together. And if this is going at, this one right here is going at 40 dB. Actually, this one's going at 20 dB. And this one's going at 40 dB. That means our slope is going to be a little bit less steep. So we'll say something like this. And so that is a very, very rough approximation of the magnitude for this graph. It's going to look something like this. Definitely not the same, but that's okay because this is just a rough estimate. And the previous video will be in the playlist linked below the like button with the rest of this problems for network analysis. This was the phase, and this was just for the magnitude.